It is now about 15 minutes before 12 on the second day of Kislev, the day that the Sforim are to be returned to the library here. The Rebbe had left the building for a short while and he should be coming back momentarily. There are countless numbers of people who came especially to be here this day from Australia, from Israel, from England, from all over the world actually. And everybody is full of excitement, and we don't know, of course, what is going to be happening exactly. The word came that everybody is to go into the Beis HaMedrash, into the yeshiva, and take Sforim and learn. This is a time for studying Torah now, and not for any other kind of excitement. You can imagine the pressure and the tension that's building up here, and I think very wisely the outlet for these pent-up energies should be expended on the study of Torah.
This matter of the return of the books, from the very beginning, the Rebbe had the vision of what was important of the case, what the strategy of the lawsuit should be, and he instilled spirit in all of the lawyers in this case who sought to return these books to their rightful place at 770, and he carried out the vision of his father-in-law. So it's a very important day, and it shows the wisdom of the one person who inspired all of us from the beginning.
A little over 2 years ago, at the first time when Mr. Shestak, along with Mr. Lewin, met with the Rebbe Zuzain Gesund, it was Vov Tishrei, there was one guideline that the Rebbe set at that time. And that is, he said to Jerry, I want to win your das. I want to win over your das. And it's interesting that this Shabbos, when the Rebbe spoke about Shliches and Eved, the Rebbe mentioned again the very same concept. An Eved is Bittel. A Shliach retains his Kav Shalei, his own Das, except his Das is dedicated to fulfill the wish of the Mishaleach. It was interesting. First of all, the Rebbe Zuzain Gesund laid out at that time the entire program, the entire plan and process for this case, which though at the moment looked, appeared to be a little difficult to comprehend from a jurisprudential point of view, but later has proven to be very accurate, as Mr. Shestak and Mr. Lewin themselves realized later.
For me in particular, I've had two zechuyot from this case. One zechut is seeing those books carried in by the shlichim of Chabad and restored to their rightful place in the Chabad community. And the other zechut, one that I shall remember throughout all my life, is the 2 hours I spent with the Rebbe.
A word was the Rebbe Shlito bringt in nomen von friedigen Rebben. Man hat es gedruckt in Hayum Yum. Was Agav, the Hayum Yum is a kleiner Sefer in Format und von die Gereste vor ihm in Teuchen. Das gedenkt sich mir, wenn ich gehad im Schuss zu sein beim friedlichen Reben, und wo es so gehandelt wegen dem Nomen von dem Sefer, aufzugeben ihm Hayum Yum. Und der Rebbe hat mir auch so getan damals. Hayum Yum. Das können wir verstehen in verschiedenen Fällen. Hayum Yum. Yum ist Lichtigkeit. Und das bringt Lichtigkeit. Und Hayum Yum. Ah, der Tag ist ein Tag. Er wird ausgenutzt wie ein Tag. Und ausgenutzt in der Fuller Moss.
Yeah. Amen.